I have just a few, Chief, isa lang, konting tanong lang para kay Professor Melo.
Okay, sige, go ahead.
Don't worry, Professor Melo. I will not be as exhaustive and disquisitive as your professor, Justice Yonen. Wala rito eh.
Sanay na po, Your Honor.
Sanay ka na. Anyway, as I have said, I will be very careful with you. Knowing that you are an expert of constitutional law.
Hindi naman po, Your Honor. Nag-aaral lang.
Although tinanong ka ni Justice Kagiwa about attempted felony.
Ay, wala na po akong alam sa criminal law. The real experts are behind me.
Yeah, I don't know, but this is not purely criminal law.
Apo.
Criminal law in relation to void and vagueness rule. Okay?
Apo.
Pakiipan mo yung isang slide dyan, iya. Ayan. Ayan lang naman ang aking tatanong sa iyo eh. Void for vagueness or over breath. It involves facial challenge or as applied. Tama po.
Opo.
When we say facial challenge, it is a contextual challenge. There is no specific person involved.
Opo.
Whereas, as applied, there is now a person involved. And there is a prejudice that is forthcoming.
Ay, mali po. Ang facial challenge may person as involved applied, and there's a prejudice.
As applied, ang sinasabi
ko. Hindi din po. Facial challenge involves a person who is actually also
as
being
applied,
burdened.
Ang sinasabi ko, Pro.
Ay, kaya nga po. Under constitutional law, facial challenge also involves a case or controversy where a person's rights are burdened. It is a misnomer to say that there's no case or controversy in a facial challenge. That's different from criminal law.
See, ano yung as applied?
As applied, Your Honor, is someone who has actually suffered criminal prosecution under the law.
There is
different
already,
po yun. Pending
already,
case is not actual
yes,
case.
There is already a person who is
criminally charged,
yes,
Your Honor.
Yes, that is what I am saying.
Yes,
as,
Your
as,
Honor.
That is my understanding of big for bigness rule.
Yes, Your Honor. Tama po kayo.
Criminal law.
Yes, Your
Kaya
Honor.
Nga criminal law nandyan.
Opo. Kasi nga, ang facial challenge, halimbawa
yes.
po, yung mga madre under support, their
yes.
rights to believe are already burdened. Kasi kung madre ka under the ATA, magbigay ka lang ng alms. Kulong ka na. For life imprisonment. That's a religious burden. Yes. Yes, Your Honor.
Wala akong issue dyan.
Ah, yes, Your Honor.
Ang sinasabi ko lang yung as applied in terms of criminal law.
Yes, Your Honor.
Ay, yung sinasabi mo mga madre, walang kinalaman ng criminal law doon.
Sige po, Your Honor.
So, our jurisprudence is this void for vagueness rule does not apply to criminal law.
Not true, Your Honor.
Not true.
Not true. And I'm quoting Vicente V. Mendoza, one of our esteemed constitutionalists, Your Honor. That's not true. There's the interim effect. I believe that is what you are referring
yes,
to, Your Honor.
Yes, yes,
that
yes.
That does not apply
correct.
To a facial challenge.
Yan ang sabi ni Bibi Mendoza eh.
Hindi po. Kausap ko po si Bibi Mendoza several times, lalo na po sa constitutional law cluster. Hindi daw po yun ang ibig sabihin niya at sinulat niya po yan sa mga
decision
right, niya.
We know specifically, Estrada, ano sinabi na Estrada about void for vagueness rule.
That is the general rule with as applied challenges. If it doesn't involve a fundamental right or a penal law that affects free speech, general rule. This ATA is the exception.
In apply by general rule. Sa Estrada.
Yes, Your Honor. Plunder yun.
Okay, plunder. But
that's not a speech act.
But it is not facial challenge.
It was a facial challenge by Pacifico Agabin, our former dean, Your Honor.
Professor, sandali. Pakinggan mo muna ako.
Yes, Your Honor. Sorry, sorry.
Eh, nainunahan mo ang musgado.
Sorry, Your Honor. Sorry, Your Honor.
Kaya ako as applied, sinabi ko sa Estrada, dahil nandyan na si Estrada. Kung wala si Estrada, would you think that will be applied?
Your Honor, in Estrada versus Desierto, it was actually a facial challenge filed. May Pacifico Agabin. But the Honorable Court treated it as an as-applied.
Because
there was somebody charged.
Exactly. Yan na sinasabi ko. Andyan na si Estrada.
Yes po.
Kung wala si Estrada, would you say the same ruling will be applied?
Oh, differently po.
Oh, yan na. That's what I'm saying. Inuuna
yes, Your Honor.
Kasi ako eh. In the same way as the other cases, as applied ang ginamit.
Aling other cases po, Your Honor? Di sini, facial po yun. Nicholas Lewis is facial.
Alright. Alright. Okay. I agree. It is only in that crime of Di sini where a facial challenge without any specific person involved that void per vagueness rule was applied.
Unfortunately, Your Honor, I have to disagree kasi may Imbong versus Ochoa ka pa. May
is
Obde
that a criminal offense?
Yes, Your Honor. That Imbong versus Ochoa? RH law?
RH law.
Yes, Your Honor. Because the doctors, right. Religious belief, they will go to jail if they don't prescribe an abortifacient.
It is a criminal offense. I will agree on that point. Madali naman akong kausap eh.
Salamat po, Your Honor.
And what is the reason why void for vagueness rule was applied?
In which case po? Sa
yung Imbong? Sinasabi mong
Imbong. Yes, Your Honor. Because precisely of the vagueness, Your Honor, it chills. Actually, the phrase of the Honorable Court
right
actually says
expression
it
or
chills.
Freedom of expression is involved. Kasi
yes, Your Honor.
Kasi hindi lang naman sabihin, ipinapahaba mo pa eh.
Yes, Your Honor.
Similarly, in this city, freedom of expression
yes,
is
Your
involved.
Honor. In other words, fundamental rights.
In all of these cases, void for vagueness rule involves that protected right of expression.
Yes, Your Honor, I agree.
You agree. Can you tell me the nature of the crimes involved in those instances where void for vagueness rule was applied?
Nature?
Yes, nature of the crime.
I'm not sure what
you
the question asks
sure.
For, Your Honor.
I will refresh your criminal law.
Yes, Your Honor.
There are 14 titles in the revised penal code, correct?
Mas magaling po kayo sa akin sa criminal law. Wala pa ako, hindi ko po maalam.
Pastirian eh.
Tama po kayo.
14 titles.
Opo.
Crimes against property, alam mo yan. Crimes against persons, title 8. Title 10, property. 11, your favorite one, crimes against chastity. Hindi ba?
Not my favorite.
Title 4. Biro lang. Title 4, joke. Title 4, public interest. Title 2, ayan siguro favorite mo.
Crimes against public order?
No. Crimes against the fundamental laws of the land. Okay. Andyan yung 1-4, 1-5, 1-6, arbitrary detention. Nandyan yung offending religious feelings. Nandyan yung search, unreasonable search, domicile, etc., etc.
Opo.
Ayan. Now, refresh with that kinds of crimes. Would you tell the court what are the nature of the crimes in those cases where void for vagueness rule was applied? Say nothing. Just tell me and I will tell you what is the nature of the crime where void for vagueness rule was applied.
Crimes against
yes.
The fundamental laws of
the just tell me the case.
Imbong.
Imbong. What is the crime involved?
Your Honor, failure to prescribe an abortifacient.
What is the nature of the crime?
It's a special law, Your Honor. So I don't know where in the RPC it falls under.
It's not, it's a special law.
RH law kasi yun, Your Honor. Eh.
Kaya nga. But if it involves falsification, public interest yan.
Ah, ganun po ba? Sige,
yes.
Your Honor.
Yes. But if involves abortion, Title 8 yan.
Yes, Your Honor.
Against person. Tama?
Yes, Your Honor.
Right, imbong. Next.
Di sini, Your Honor.
Di sini.
The Cybercrime Act.
All right. What is the nature of the crime of cybercrime law?
The nature of the crime of cybercrime
yes.
Law? Crime against public order?
public order, pwede. But specifically, it involves a crime against public interest. Bakit public interest?
I believe it is against the public interest for these cyber attacks to happen.
Social media is involved. It involves the interest of the public.
Opo.
Social media, hindi ba?
Opo.
All right. And you are saying that Ochoa and that of Dicini, both cases are applicable to Anti-Terrorism Act.
Opo.
Yes, sir. Void for vagueness rule.
Opo.
Because it also involved freedom of expression.
And fundamental rights.
Yes, sir. Yes, freedom of expression na sinabi ko na eh. Okay. Now, next question. What is the nature of the crime involved in terrorism law?
Based on your questioning, Your Honor, maybe public order as well.
Public and, order public, and terrorism?
Interest? A crime against public order? And
public
a crime
order
against
and terrorism?
Interest? I believe so, Your Honor.
Crimes, kanina pa natin pinag-uusapan, national security.
Ah, opo, opo.
Hindi ba?
Opo, opo.
In our jurisprudence, never did we use that void for vagueness use in crimes involving national security.
I will have to check
in fact,
you on.
Southern Hemisphere said that is not applicable.
Well, Your Honor, Southern Hemisphere is not a free speech case, Your Honor, because that's what Carpio Morales, this Carpio Morales, my client, said in her ponencia. It was not treated as a fundamental rights case, Your Honor.
Same as the terrorism law, which is classified as a crime against national interest.
Well, Your Honor, now, I would really, really mo, beg to disagree mo, that if we're going to carve out... Yes, Your Honor.
I will give you a chance to talk. Don't worry. Pakinggan mo lang ako.
Opo. Sorry.
Because I have surveyed all these cases, never in our jurisprudence, where this void for vagueness rule was applied in a facial challenge, particularly if we're talking facial challenge, void for vagueness rule was applied in crimes involving national security.
Terrorism po.
Yes. You know nothing pinag-uusapan. Never.
Yes, Your Honor. And may I respond?
Teka muna.
Sige po.
Tapusin mo lang ako at hindi tayo magkakaintindihan if you will go on with me.
Okay po.
Tapusin mo lang ako. I will give you a chance. Since this involves a crime against national security, it is more than the fundamental rights. Why? Because what is affected in crimes against national security is not only the people's right, correct? In national security of the state, what is involved? The right of the people, the state's right to its sovereignty, to its government, and that of its territory. Tama?
Tama po kayo.
Okay. That is why, because of this broadness and danger that lurks behind the enactment of the law, void for vagueness rule was never applied even in some other countries. In other words, here, speaking of crimes against national security, the main issue is not the presence of that right freedom of expression, but rather the compelling state interest to justify that freedom of expression that you are now invoking before this court. If I may show you this slide. Last slide. In other words, the focus of the anti-terrorism law should be national, state, and security. As such, the real issue is whether the state has compelling interest to restrict the individual's fundamental right.
May I respond, Your Honor?
Huwag lang matagal. Dahil
yan lang po.
Sige.
May nakalimutan po. May second element sa compelling state interest, narrow tailoring. Pag may compelling state interest ka, the means have to be narrowly tailored. If we do not allow facial challenges, even if inuubos na ang mga tao, isagad na po natin national security. I thought you wanted me to answer. I will back out.
You're not telling me the test.
Yes, Your Honor.
Compelling state interest versus right of the people, fundamental right. Ayan ang test. And what are the tests? Do we use? Yun ang sasabihin ko ngayon. Inunahan mo kasi yun na naman ako po. Di ba? Rational. Rational. Ano? Rational. Ano? Rational test. Or reasonable test. Tama? Intermediate. Intermediate test. Strict scrutiny test. These are being applied. Correct?
Strict scrutiny pag fundamental right.
Yes, ayan na nga sinasabi ko. Strict scrutiny. But since, as I have shown there, it is the national state security which is involved, there may be a higher level of scrutiny more than the strict scrutiny test.
Ang tinetest po ng strict scrutiny, yung state, yes, hindi yung po yung right to free
right
speech. Baliktad po.
Right of the state versus the fundamental. Binaliktad ko specifically because what is involved here is the state, its interest and security, and not the fundamental law of the land.
Well, yan I would have to beg, right. Very respectfully all beg right. To disagree, all Your right. Honor. The
right.
Burden is on the state if it chose unconstitutional
okay.
Means. Strict scrutiny of
Professor,
the means,
Professor,
not of the person's right.
Dakdak ka na naman ng dakdak mamaya. In-anticipate mo lahat ng sinasabi ko
eh.
If you disagree, I will give you a chance. Don't
Opo.
Worry. And this is your chance. After I have said everything, this is your chance. Next. File your memorandum to that effect after the Solicitor General has said its piece. Hindi tayo matatapos if I will let you talk and talk. Tama?
Yes, Your Honor.
All right. Thank you, Professor.
Yes, Your Honor. Thank you very much, Your Honor. And my apologies, Your Honor.
Yun lang gusto ko lang sabihin, yung point ng husgado.
Salamat po, Your Honor.
Iniintindi namin kayo.
Salamat
po. Yung pagkaintindi na namin, ibigay nyo sa amin kung ano yung pagkaintindi nyo sa batas. And we cannot take those things here in the oral argument because we have a limited time.
Opo, we will include it in our memorandum,
After,
Your Honor.
Kasi baka naman sasagutin ka na ng sergeant
Ay, opo.
Eh.
Opo.
Di ba?
Opo.
Kung hindi kasi that will be, and maybe I will also include that if ever that issue will come out in the course of the resolution of the court of your petition.
Salamat po, Your
Salamat
Honor.
Salamat din,
Pasensya
Professor.
Na po, Your Honor.
Chief, I am done. Okay.